weeks ago, we got this call from Gary in California, who wanted to know about SiTime. That's a small cap maker of timing chips. They're using everything, smartwatches, data centers, planes, automobiles, big market. If you're doing some homework, I circled back to this one a few days later. It said that SiTime looked like a pretty good opportunity. It might be early. This is a tough story for anyone who's not an electrical engineer to get their head around, which I am not, which is why we were thrilled when the company reached out to us and offered to come on the show to explain their what they do directly. So let's take a closer look with Rajesh Washish. He's the chairman and CEO of SiTime to learn more about what they do. Mr. Washish, welcome to Mad Money.
Hey, Jim, thanks so much for having me.
Okay.
It's a real pleasure to be here.
Oh, you're very kind. You're very kind. I want people to understand what they own. That's really important.
That's
and
right.
I think people have to start with, what are precision timing solutions used for?
That's right. So timing is the heartbeat of all electronics. Every electronics you can think of needs a timing chip. About 15 years ago, we decided to revolutionize the market, take out the 70-year-old technology, which is quartz-based crystals,
right,
and change it to semiconductors. And as you know, semiconductors always wins when it goes up against non-semiconductors. That's our business.
Well, wait. I mean, quartz has been time immemorial. Quartz is the toughest thing in the world. Why wouldn't quartz work for everything else?
Well, because it's not semiconductors. Semiconductors is the best technology ever known. We are programmable. We're 1/25th the size. We can take 50,000 G-forces as compared to 2,000 G-forces. We can be connected to, built in a fab, the quality, reliability, all of those things just make it ideal. Semiconductors.
So something like aerospace, where you really have to worry about, or data centers where they can burn real hot, these all work for you.
That's right. And so, for example, Google or Meta or anybody who's in a hyperscaler business would like to use our parts, perhaps in the opticals, perhaps in the interconnect, or, as you said, aerospace, SpaceX, or customers like that in the low Earth orbit satellites. That's a great market for us.
Well, are you one of the reasons why a smartwatch is just so much more exciting and informative than my old dumb quartz watch?
That's right. And we have some of the biggest smartwatch makers in the world that use our product. And one in particular, Garmin, for example, uses our parts all the time.
Now, you also have in the last quarter you talked about, in general, our Chinese business is robust. I thought that was interesting, and it's a meaningful part of your revenue, because a lot of people aren't seeing good business in China. Why is your business doing so well there?
Yeah, so part of our business in China is the automotive business. And we own 60% of all Chinese EVs. We're in 80% of all U.S. EVs. So electric vehicles, which are also a short way of saying automated driving, radar, LiDAR, cameras, you know, the displays, all of them work with our chips.
So, like, assisted driving, how does that, do you play in that world?
So, you need 12 cameras that tell you what sensor's coming in. You need a radar, you need LiDAR, you need smart mirrors, and all of that that computes with a hyper-performance computing system, any kind of AI system, perhaps a Dojo system, any of those.
Now, when I look at your total adjustable market, first I think, well, I know people say it's $8 billion, $10 billion, but if everything uses you, conceivably we shouldn't even be thinking about total addressable market. It's just whatever device needs to be smarter, it might be yours. So if there's artificial intelligence making things smarter, there's a reason to believe that you might be part of artificial intelligence.
That's right. So giving credit to the quartz industry, as you said earlier, 70 years they've been doing a fantastic job. Right. We're not trying to displace them. We're not a market share game. We are delivering chips, precision timing chips that we invented with our MEMS technology that are so dramatically different. So that's why we're 85% single source with our customers. This is a great place for us to be, given that there's 40 purveyors of quartz crystal. We're the only ones in this technology.
Now, when you say MEMS, that's microelectromechanical systems. So, I mean, this is just something that you guys, no one else has that?
Nobody has this kind of MEMS. You know, you and I are very familiar with circuits, and circuits are electrical circuits.
Right.
MEMS is moving parts. Moving parts in silicon. So we have resonators that vibrate for 30 years at millions times a second and without any failures. How great is that?
Wow, that's incredible. And I love the fact that, I mean, when I look at all the different, you've got some great stuff in changing the world of timing. You created precision timing.
That's
no
right.
one had done this before you?
Yeah, so I love being a category creator. My previous company, I did that. I like to go into large markets. At the time when we started here, it was a $5 billion market. Now it's 10, it's headed to be a $20 billion market, and disrupt that. That is where great companies are made.
Okay, now we know from NVIDIA, we know from AMD, they do fabless semi. You do fabless semi too.
They're absolutely fabless semi. We do our MEMS chips at Bosch in Stuttgart in Germany. They're leaders. And we do our analog chips at TSMC in Taiwan.
Oh,
another
okay.
leader.
Now, what you need to know is that there was a, you had this really boom period, and then there was an inventory glut.
That's right.
Now, where are we in terms of working that off? Because I know, and I always tell people, look, when you're a quarter away from the end of that, you can't wait till after it's over. Then the stock is already going up big. Where do you think we are in this cycle?
So what we did, what happened was that our customers overordered.
Right.
Things were tough during the pandemic.
Overordered, they double ordered because they needed it really badly.
Exactly.
They weren't dumb. They just needed it really badly.
Exactly. And they didn't want to have shortages, and we supported them. But now they realize that they have built too much inventory between themselves and their contract manufacturers. Now they've been bringing it all down.
Right.
Demand is ticking up. We believe that Q2 was our lowest quarter. We went up by about 28% in Q3, and we've guided to about 15 to 20% up in Q4 of this year.
Of which you said there are many new customers, not just the same old, which I thought was really significant, because that can come in and burn through all the inventory.
That's right. We also have new customers, new use cases. We have 300 use cases, 15,000 customers.
Wow. This might be the time. Now, this might be the time. Look, I mean, everyone's waiting for the time for ADL, you know, Vance Micro. They're all waiting for Intel. This may be the time for your company. So I'm so glad that you came on right now.
Well, I'm so glad. And, you know, it's the people that make this company great, and we build a great culture. Magic happens at SiTime.
Magic happens. There we go. That's Rajesh.
Thank you.
Washis, he's the chairman, president, and CEO of SiTime. Thank you, Gary, for bringing us a very exciting story. Man Money's back at the break.